The crime drama Longmire is sure to make anyone addicted to it. Based on the best-selling series of novels by Craig Johnson, the show has been able to make quite the mark, especially after it got picked up by Netflix for its last three seasons. Today, in this video, we will be looking at some of the behind-the-scenes moments from this show that will for sure leave all the mystery and the thrill behind for you. Before jumping straight into the video, make sure to hit the like button and subscribe to the channel to watch more videos like these. And don't forget to hit the bell icon as well so you get notified every time we upload a new video. So, let's get into the video. Craig Johnson made sure to bring new scenes to the table. This show is based on the crime mystery novel series of Craig Johnson. The author made sure to bring something new to the TV series, something that is not present in his books. The reason for this was that he wanted to make sure that the people who have already read the novels had something else to look forward to, and the people who haven't yet read the books could go read them too. Something or the other for everyone to keep the mystery running and alive. For instance, in the book, the town of Absaroka had a total of only 5 murders in 24 years. However, in the series, each episode portrayed a different murder story. One of the greatest plot twists of the show was how the wife of Walt Longmire died. In the book, she died due to cancer, but in the series, they portrayed her death as a murder. Craig Johnson wanted every viewer of the series to get excited with the next scene and not figure out what would happen next, and he absolutely made sure that the series contained some scenes and plot twists that not even the ones who had read the books from before could figure out as well. Tiny details and thoughts like these kept the show as one of the best crime series to date. The entire series was mostly filmed in New Mexico. The show features the fictional town of Absaroka County in northern Wyoming, but in reality, the entire show was mostly filmed in New Mexico. The reason why they picked New Mexico was to make sure that the very essence of the fictional town that the series is based on, Absaroka County, was still present, and this very location also helped the cast members grow and develop into their characters more. The show creators and producers wanted to keep the set as real as possible. Other locations that the show was filmed in include parts of Las Vegas, Red River, Eagle Nest, and Española. The sheriff's office, for example, was filmed in Las Vegas. All of these locations were carefully hand-picked to make the most out of Absaroka County and make sure that the background and setting matched to the maximum with the book to give the viewers the full experience. Why the author and the casting directors wanted to cast Robert Taylor. Robert Taylor is an Australian actor, and the character Walt Longmire is all about what one can say about an American. But the actor himself has done such an outstanding job that no one can ever tell that he is actually Australian. The character of Walt Longmire in the show is very different from how this character was portrayed in the books. As we told you earlier in the video, the author himself wanted some elements of the series to be portrayed differently to keep something new for everyone. In the books, Walt Longmire is a humorous and witty man, but in the series, he's not portrayed like this. This was a point that not many fans took to heart, but actually applauded the actor and the show creators for this new change in the main character's role. Robert Taylor did the role justice, and no one in this world could have played Walt Longmire better than him. Other than Walt Longmire's role, the author Craig Johnson also had a part in other casting decisions as well. If a show is based on a book, then obviously the author has some role in the real-life version too. Craig Johnson was very active with the casting decisions of each character, and tries his best to make sure that the actors themselves grow into the characters of the show. Why the filming of Season 2 was halted in 2013. As mentioned earlier in this video, most of the scenes of the show were filmed in New Mexico. In 2013, during the filming of Season 2, the shooting of the film was postponed for a while due to the wildfires that occurred all around the sets of the show. The show creators decided to not go on with the shoot, as they did not want to interrupt the local people trying to combat the many difficult wildfires that occurred. While fighting those wildfires in that area, many firefighters, about 19 in number, lost their lives protecting the houses and the people of that area. The show made sure to pay them a tribute at the end of Season 2 to honor their acts of heroism and bravery. The show got canceled by A&E after 3 seasons. This might come as a shock to all of you. The very reason that Longmire was canceled by A&E after 3 very successful seasons was because the show creators found that most of the viewers of the show were the elderly, that is, people aged between 45 to 60. The show premiered with very amazing views and ratings. After each season, the percentage of the ratings grew, and despite all of this success, A&E decided to end the show. Another surprising reason for A&E to cancel the show was because they wanted to produce shows that were owned by just them, as Longmire was created under the banner of Warner Horizon. It was all thanks to Netflix, who came to the rescue rescue as always and picked the show up, which went on for 3 more seasons. Imagine how the world would have been robbed of the mystery and magic that the last 3 seasons of the show gave us if it weren't for Netflix picking it up where it last left off. The show received even more ratings and success after it went on Netflix, and the audience of the show consisted of millennials as well. The fans are still expecting the show to come up with another season, but that is highly unlikely, as by the ending of season 6, it looks as if the show has reached a finale after all. Deputy Victoria was not very friendly in the beginning of season 1. One of the most loved characters and actor, Katie Sackhoff, was not very friendly in season 1. The actress herself confronted this and said that her attitude around her other castmates was very negative, especially with Bailey Chase, who plays the role of Branch Connolly. But she soon realized where she was going wrong and did not shy away from making amends. There was no Jacob Nighthorse in the novel series. The very famous book series of this show did not have any villain by the name of Jacob Nighthorse. This character was created for the TV storyline only. The audience wants to watch a show that is filled with heroes and villains at the same time. The villainous character of Jacob Nighthorse was created just for the show, and of course the viewers and, well, the creators of the show and the author of the book did a very exceptional job in bringing this villain character to life from scratch just for the TV series. Did you know that many of the episodes were directed by Peter Weller? Lucian Connolly, who was seen as a recurring role in the series, was Walt's predecessor, who also trained him under his wing. This character was played by the talented actor Peter Weller, whom we all know. But what most of you don't know is that Peter Weller also directed many episodes of the show. The episodes he directed were from seasons 1, 4, 5, and 6. Talk about a man who can do it all. What would the show look like if Kylie Chandler had played the part of Longmire? We can't imagine anyone else playing the role of Walt Longmire other than Robert Taylor, who brought his own element into the character and made the main character different from the books, in a good way, of course. Did you know that the role almost went to Kyle Chandler? Chandler himself is an amazing actor and would have brought his own style to the show. His other projects have been nothing but a hit. However, whatever happened, happened for a good reason, and the show became a hit with Robert Taylor as Walt Longmire. The storyline, plot twists, cast, and the team behind this incredible show made it the success it is today. While many fans are waiting for season 7, it looks as if the show has ended for good with the finale of season 6. That's it for today's video. We will see you in the next one.